Hi guys, welcome to this session with the title Empower Digital Transformation in Your Organization with a Power Platform. I would have preferred to meet all of you live, but this event allows us to remain in contact anyway during this COVID-19 period. A big thanks to our sponsor, who helped to organize this great event, and I'm proud to propose this session. Few words about me. My name is Marco Rocca, and I'm a senior PFE in Modern Workplace Domain in Microsoft Italy. I love SharePoint since 2008, and I followed all SharePoint evolution, then SharePoint 2010, 13, etc., and now SharePoint Online. But I don't work only with SharePoint, I work to all Microsoft 365 products, for example, Planner, To-Do, Stream, Form, etc. But in the last 3 years, I'm focusing on Power Platform, then Power Apps, Power Automate, Power Virtual Agent. The agenda of this session is very simple because I propose you an introduction to Power Platform, what's new and what's next for Power Apps, Power Automate and Power Virtual Agent, because I'm not a Power BI expert. And at the end of this session, I'll show you two real business cases. The first business case regard how it's possible manage document into your organization with the Power Platform, and the second case regard an example of a product catalog. Okay, we're starting with the first point, introduction to Power Platform. Microsoft 3 years ago reinvented how it's possible create application and all business process in your organization. For example, now you have a Microsoft Teams that is the hub for the small collaboration in your organization. Okay, within Microsoft Teams, the user can find all for their work because it's possible chat with other user. It's possible organize a meeting, but now it's possible embed in Microsoft Teams several applications, several Microsoft Flow or external data. For example, I could include in a channel, for example, a YouTube tab that allow the user to see the video from their organization channel in YouTube. But Microsoft Teams is based on SharePoint. Then SharePoint remain the main product for a large collaboration. Then it's possible collect, manage, distribute content using Microsoft SharePoint list and document library. But near SharePoint and Microsoft Teams, now you have Power Apps for create no code app. And remember that with Power Apps is the only way that you have to customize SharePoint list and document library forms. Today, also, you have more than 300 connectors for create a large number of Power Automate processes. For example, you could create processes that join data that are not only in Microsoft 365 platform, but for example are in Google Drive or for example in SAP. At the end, you have a constellation of tools that allow you to improve your application. For example, you have artificial intelligence builder, or it's possible today create a chatbot without code. Or if you need to connect several data in Microsoft 365, you could use Microsoft Graph. That's why I welcome you to the Power Platform world. Power Platform have today four main components: Power BI for the business analytics, Power Apps for application development, Power Automate for process automation, and Power Virtual Agent for creating a chatbot without code. But all of these components are based on data connector, but it's not only, it's possible to create a public portal to expose your data using Power Apps portal. You already know Artificial Intelligence Builder, and remember that it's important understand that you have a common data services in your environment. Common data services could be a simple database where it's possible to save your application data. You have already a set of entities, for example, a standard entity could be product, user, contact, etc. But you could create a several list of custom entity that you need for your application. I like this slide because what's mean? This slide mean that this is a no-code session. In all my application, in all my demo, I don't write any statement of C# or TypeScript code. It's completely no-code session. And remember this slogan: less code, more power. Okay, what's new today for Power Apps? The big feature is that today it's possible to integrate easily your application into Microsoft Teams. The first point is very, very fast deployed your app in Microsoft Teams, just one, two click. It's possible to deploy your app directly to Power App Studio or direct using Microsoft Teams in channel add a Power Apps tab. But if this is not enough, I can pin my app in the left sidebar of Microsoft Teams. This is another improvement for Power Apps and Teams integration. It's a big improvement for citizen developer. Context parameters for adaptive integration. Because this improvement enables the developer to create app to be consumed in a Microsoft Teams context. What's that mean? This means that apps can now be created understanding where the app is hosted. In the past, you need to create several applications for a different channel because the app cannot understand where is hosted. But now, using context parameter, it's possible to create only one application for a different channel, for example. And this is a very, very big improvement. The second feature regarding Power App Studio. Power App Studio will be embedded direct in Microsoft Teams. Then you don't have two different environment: Power App Studio create an app, then deploy an app into Microsoft Teams, but Power App Studio will be embedded directly in Teams. This allows you to create a modern application direct using the modern Teams control app that will be responsive and using Teams object. Another feature is regarding common data services. Because today, to see data in common data services, the only way is to use the standard interface, for example, in Power Apps Studio. but now will be possible use your SQL Server Management Studio. Then will be possible create a custom query, see your data, see your view in common data services. It's a big and beautiful improvement. And the second option, it's possible create a query for Power BI directly from common data services. This is my preferred feature, mixed reality in Power Apps. You have four different modes to integrate mixed reality in your application. The first mode is validate the fit before work begin. What's mean? As you see in this image, it's possible validate the fit of the object direct in the real context using device camera. Or the second way could be using three-dimensional model, and I could put my model in Power Apps Gallery and propose this model into my real context, always using my device camera. I could take measurement, for example, of my room. And the last is if I don't have a three-dimensional model, but I have only 2D, two-dimensional model, I can put my two-dimensional model into my real context. Okay, as you can see in the last image in this slide. Okay, it's a very, very powerful feature for Power Apps. How to do this? Mixed reality feature is an experimental feature, then I need to enable it. When I check on this feature, you can see three different control: view in mixed reality, view shape in mixed reality, measure, or you see view 3D model in your Power App. One important note, your 3D content must be in Jellyby file format. This is only format allowed for your model at the moment in Power Apps. Another important topic regarding how it's possible to integrate the map into your application. Then it's possible create an interactive map in your application with the zoom, rotation, etc. function. It's possible to switch from road map to satellite view, and we'll have in the future an address suggestion control that enable you to start write your address, and the control propose you a suggestion for complete your address. Okay, I prepare a quick demo about mixed reality. Okay, this is my sample app. Loading. Okay. Today my network is not very, very fast. Sorry for this. Okay, the app is loading. Let's go. Then. Okay, it's the demo. It's the demo effect. Okay, we'll start for the moment for Geospatial feature application. Okay, I prepare another room with the Geospatial feature. Okay, this is the new map control that I have. You see that test data, for example, is an Excel file where I have the location to be pinned in my app. When I execute my map, okay, I can rotate my image. I can return to the original format. I can pitch the map, or I can use the zoom. Okay, I see the all pin, and if I zoom, I can see all detail of my pinned location. Okay. But I prepare another map. This is my current location for the moment. I'll try to insert one address. Okay, via Cinisio in Milan. I select the first one address. Okay, I insert the address in my gallery. Then is direct pinned in my app, and the map switch directly to this current location. Okay, this is the radius of the from my current location. Then I can switch to satellite view, and I can zoom in via Cinisio. In Milan, the pitch, okay, and the rotation, very, very powerful. Okay, I return to my first demo about mixed reality. Okay, file, settings. Advanced settings, I in experimental feature. Now you can see mixed reality feature. Then switch to on. Then, when in component list you have this new category, mixed reality, view mixed with all the list or control related to mixed reality. Ok. I prepare a gallery with a list of two-dimensional image. In this gallery I have a list of image. Then when I click detail, I could load in this the 3D model related to the image selected. Okay. And after this I could enable my device camera, and I could put my model in my real context. Okay, we start. This is the gallery. For example, if I select the chair, I can upload my three-dimensional model. I can move my model in my app. Okay, I could select, for example, my surface. Okay, the same mode, I can see my model. Then, when I switch to view model in mixed reality, okay, this is the final result. This is my PC in my table. And this is the three-dimensional model from the Power Apps gallery in my real context. I think that it's fantastic. Okay, I continue to my presentation. What's new for Power Automate? For Power Automate, you have two simple features. It's possible now find more easily an action in Power Automate because the interface will be changed, and you have a new expression builder for create your formula in Power Automate. But the most important feature for Power Automate is this. I think that all of you already know Adaptive Guard. And today, for create an Adaptive Guard, you could use a public site that enable you to design the Adaptive Guard. And after this, it's possible export JSON file and import, for example, in Power Automate. But in the future will be possible create an adaptive card directly in Power Automate portal. Then will be possible save the card or copy card JSON and pass the JSON directly, for example, in post an adaptive card message to your teams. Then it's another fantastic feature. And the last feature for Power Automate that I propose you is regarding when an items are created and modified trigger for SharePoint. A new action will be available to get changed for one or more column in a list or library using version. Then the action return not the column that are changed, but also the new and old value from the last execution of the flow. Very, very fantastic, another fantastic feature. For Power Virtual Agent, I summarize in this slide the three main feature. For example, the first is possible to customize a canvas for your Power Chat, for Virtual Agent chatbot. It's possible create a custom canvas with your custom style sheet or creating your custom HTML file. And the second feature is it's possible to configure the system fallback topic. What's new? In some scenario, you might want to customize the bot behavior when the user input doesn't trigger any topic. For example, you can build a topic to call backend system or route to existing services when it's for the chatbot it's impossible to reply to the user question. Then in this case is that the user could be helped to obtain a good response from your organization. And the last feature is that now it's possible create directly a Power Virtual Agent flow directly in the user in the topic conversation designer. Okay, I'm ready to start to my first demo. As possible manage contracts in Contoso or Contoso Company. Contoso would automate document contract creation based on a template. I suppose that Contoso have different type of document in your, for example, could be have a statement of work, could be have a no disclosure agreement, etc. I create a simple approved flow and Contoso would use Microsoft Teams for collaboration area. In this demo, I use all Power Platform components, Power Apps, Automate, Virtual Agent. Obviously, I use Teams and SharePoint, and I add a artificial intelligence builder to my application. Okay, we'll start with my demo. Oops, I refresh the page. I open Teams. Okay, I open Teams in app mode. Sorry. I use the web app. I also open Microsoft Power Automate. To manage contracts, I create a classic Microsoft Teams. Then I have added a contract proposal tab. This is a classic SharePoint list where the user insert the detail for create a new document. This form is customized using Microsoft Power Apps. Then I start to insert my data. For example, fiat new intranet. Company is Fiat. Then this important data, the type of document, statement of work, no disclosure agreement. I select, for example, so the contact name is Paolo Rossi. The expiration date of the contract, I suppose the end of June. The contact role is CIO. And I generate automatically a ref number for the new contract. And this is a reminder check for the contract. I don't need any reminder for this example. Then I save my data. A new record is insert in my SharePoint list. Then in Power Automate I switch to the correct environment. My flow. I select my flow, team flow. This is the flow when an item is created. The first condition is the type of document. If yes, I populate a Microsoft Word template using my SharePoint list data, for example, contact role, company, ref number, etc. After this, I create a new Word document based on this template with my data. And the last action is post an adaptive card to my Teams channel. This is a JSON of the adaptive card, and this is the dynamic data from my Power Automate flow. For example, the name of the contract, the company, document type, expiration date, and I insert a button in my adaptive card to see the contract directly from Teams. Another option is more simple, is to post a simple message in my Teams. Then if I go here, this is the correct time, new contract generated, fiat new internet, the type so, expiration date, the end of June. I can open my document directly. This is a Word document. There's our data that I have inserted in my SharePoint list. Fiat CIO Paolo Rossi. Then in SharePoint I could work with my document. After I finished to work to my document, I can ask to my manager to approve my contract. This is another flow. Approve contract. Please approve my contract. Run flow. Okay, I switch this because I have another. Okay, I need to switch to another user. Just a second to simulate my manager. Portal.office. I go from Outlook and I hope to see the mail. Okay, this is the last mail. Fiat New Intranet is the last contract. I approve it. Okay, for me. I insert a comment. Okay, for me. And I send the request. Okay. Then I have another Microsoft Flow. I'll see you to this environment that is called approve contract. Ok, this is the current flow for selected file. I start the approval. If the approval it's okay, I'll post a message in a bot, in a channel. Then I convert my document to PDF. Ok, I convert the document e I move the file in archive section. Then, if you see in archive session, I've moved my last, just a second that I find it. I try to refresh. Ok, Fiat New Intranet is moved to archive section. Ok, but now, ok, I have generated the PDF file of the contract, but for example, approver needed to apply, for example, a digital signature to my contract. Then I create, for example, a new tab in approver channel. Could be approver channel, could be a private channel. Ok, I create a new tab. I insert these custom power-ups. Then I can see Fiat New Intranet sample. I can show the preview using PDF viewer control for power-ups. This is the last. Then, for example, I could call a custom digital signature web service to apply the signature to my document. Ok, then it's possible to home. Ok, now Fiat New Intranet is under signed category. But if I have already a contract, what is possible to do? For example, I have already a statement of work that I need to archive into my SharePoint site. Ok, for this situation I could use an upload new contract. I could use an artificial intelligence builder control that scan my document. Then, for example, I select PowerUp Workshop PDF. Then artificial intelligence builder analyzed all data in my document e put the recognized data directly to my power up field. I need only to insert the title of the document. Okay, and I can save it directly to my SharePoint. Okay, sample Ferrari artificial intelligence, then it's possible archive direct my document in SharePoint without all approval process. Well, but for the moment I see a standard mode for create an approval process for my document, okay? But it's possible propose another way for the data entry and create a new request. This is a classic web page, and this is a chatbot that could help your user to create a new contract request. Okay, the chatbot asks me how is possible enter new request. The title is sample chat bot to May. The company is Contoso. The document type, for example, I select always sold. The expiration date, the end of July, in this case, contact name, I insert my name, for example, rule, PFE, no, want a reminder, then I complete the request, okay, perfect, now the chatbot tell me that have received my contract request. For me the response is correct and is excellent. Okay, now in my list, in contract details, chatbot insert a new record. Okay, then if all works correctly, now the flow post an adaptive guard in my teams, and I can continue my approval process. Okay, this is the new statement of work, Contoso, Marco Rocca, PFE. As you can see in this demo, no code is a classic approval process without any line of code based on all Power Platform components. But I prepare another demo. Okay, how is possible manage now not a document, but a classic product catalog. Product catalog is based on SharePoint list. Okay, and we'll create easily an application to enable user to create an order and have a classic flow to approve the process, the purchase process. Okay. In this case, I switch to another user to simulate a standard user. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Also, this demo is based on Microsoft Teams. Then the user open Teams. I open Teams using web app in web app mode. Okay, then I have a new team that is marketing, and I have a new power app. Okay, device ordering. Where it's possible select my device that I want to buy. For example, I would buy a Surface. Okay, for example, a Surface Pro and one Lenovo. Okay, I could compare, for example, to the feature of two device. Then I add to cart two elements, then it's no, I remove, ok, no, I'll buy two device, then it's possible to send a order to my manager. Ok, perfect, my order is submitted successfully. Perfect. I return to, for example, to manager. Ok. And I'll go to my Outlook. Oops. Outlook. Ok. Then I'm waiting to receive my mail from Microsoft Flow. Okay, and all data are saved on SharePoint, SharePoint list. Okay, well, is the current request. Okay, I could approve the order. Okay, then in manage device order, the flow post a new adaptive card. Just a second to see the result. Okay, it's approved. Well, this is the today request from Marco Crespi with the current cost. I can see the order details in this adaptive card, but the best features that I could generate directly the invoice for this order. What's mean? I press this button in my adaptive card. This invoice is based on a work template in the same mode. Okay. The invoice at the end of the order is converted to PDF, but you can see that in this invoice I don't have only either the data of the order, but it's possible insert all detail from my order. It's another best feature for create a complex document for your organization using, for example, Power Automate. And in Teams you can see the adaptive card to manage this order. The process finished using send, for example, the same invoice directly to the user. This is Marco Crespi, and this is the invoice of your dei road. done using Power Apps, Power Automate. It's possible manage all order. I return to demo environment in the my team flow list. This is the flow. Manage device order. Ok, starting waiter approval. In this case I using non a standard waiter approval, but the action where is possible customize the response option. Ok, then you can add your custom option, and if the order is approved, I populate a work template for my invoice, and in this case you see invoice details is an array that contains all detail of my order. Then I convert my document to PDF, and the last option is send an email to the user. And an adaptive card in my Teams using in this case two action buttons. Ok, I finish my presentation. There are my contacts. If you have several questions, contact me on the social network, LinkedIn or Twitter, or contact me directly to my work address. And very thanks for your attention, and I hope to meet you live in the next event. Thanks so much. Bye.